up or I'll shoot. All right, get your hands up. Put a light on him.
Axford?
You know him?
Yeah.
It's Mike Axford, police reporter on the Daily Sentinel.
Another challenge for the Green Hornet, his aide Cato, and their rolling arsenal, the Black Beauty. On police records, a wanted criminal, the Green Hornet is really Britt Reed, owner publisher of the Daily Sentinel. His dual identity known only to his secretary and to the district attorney. And now, to protect the rights and lives of decent citizens, rides the Green Hornet. The Green Hornet is brought to you by...
I see. Thanks.
I'm sorry, Britt, but the butler didn't make it. It's first-degree murder now.
You think Mike is a killer?
I don't know what to think. The evidence seems to indicate it.
Evidence? What evidence? Except Mike happened to be in the neighborhood.
And tried to run from the police. And take a look at this.
Urbanite magazine. What about it?
Yeah, turn to the page that's marked here. There it is. Mike Axford's byline in last week's edition.
That's right. I gave him my okay to write it.
But that's not the point. This is an interview with Alonzo Linden. That's the owner of the home that was robbed tonight. That's the scene of the killing.
Couldn't that be a coincidence?
Oh? What about these? Are they coincidences? There are four articles, three burglaries of the subject's homes, over $1 million in loot. Somebody's been using these interviews to case those homes, and I think that Mike Axford is in it up to his neck.
Sat on this side before.
Don't you feel sorry for yourself, Mike?
You're in deep trouble.
You're the only one that can help me get you out.
Now, what were you doing at the Linden place tonight?
Like I told the cops, I got to figuring. After the other homes were knocked over, I guessed the Linden house would be next. I was going to stop it. I never even got inside the place.
Much less murder anybody.
Then why did you run?
I'll never know. Me that counts the chief of police and half the force as my friends.
You used a photographer. Who was it?
Forget her. Her.
She's clean.
Well, so are you, Mike, but you're in custody.
Now, who was it?
But I've known her since she was a kid.
The name, Mike?
Artis Ralston.
Dave Ralston's daughter?
Dave died. I sort of took her under my wing. She's followed in his footsteps. A darn good photographer. And a sweet kid.
I'd better finish packing now.
You're not still stewing about that Axford character, are you?
Mike's a nice guy, Yale. Using him in the robberies without his knowing about it, that's one thing. You promised me that nobody'd get hurt.
Well, we made a few mistakes. But if it's a real problem to you, I'll get Mike off the hook before we leave town.
How?
Oh, you just leave that to me. Believe me, nothing's going to happen to Mike.
You promise?
I promise. Now make sure you pack everything. We don't want to leave any tracks behind.
Mm. I'll check one more time. After one more kiss.
Mike was trying to protect her. It's going together now, Cato.
Yes?
Yale, this is Tubbs. I've got to see you.
Oh? What about?
Yeah? Is that you? Hello? Hello?
Who was it?
Tubbs.
The fence?
Yeah, it sounded like him. He thought he was talking to somebody named Yale.
The name mean anything to you?
No, not yet. But I've got an idea where we can find some answers.
Packing the stuff in the storeroom. Hello. Yeah, Tubbs. Just a minute. Yeah.
I've been trying to reach you. I called Artis's apartment. Someone answered. They didn't say who they were. I thought it was you. They hung up.
Oh?
Yeah, oh. Now look, I know about that newspaper man getting jugged.
So?
So I don't like it. I mean, if those cops find out it was you out at that Linden place, and it was you who killed the butler.
Just relax. The cops aren't going to find out a thing.
You just fenced that jewelry I gave you.
I don't like it.
You don't have to like it. Just do it. Aldo? Murph? Chubb's getting nervous. You two get over there and give him a tranquilizer.
Green Hornet. What do you want this time?
A little information.
I know nothing about nothing.
Come on, Tubbs. You underrate yourself, as usual. This is about the latest outbreak of robberies. You
hurt nothing.
You might as well help me, Tubbs. You wouldn't want the police to receive, quite anonymously, of course, evidence that you're the largest dealer of stolen merchandise in the city, would you? I thought not. Evidently, this gang has approached some fence to get rid of its stolen jewels and...
Not me. I swear.
You don't have any information about the operation. You don't know a girl named Artis Ralston?
No.
You don't know a man named Yale?
No.
You're lying, Tubbs.
No. Now, look. I've helped you before, haven't I?
Yeah. When it was convenient to you. I'll be back, Tubbs. You think hard and stay alive. Now let's listen for a few answers. Right on schedule.
Yeah. The Green Hornet was just here.
The Green Hornet?
He was asking about you, an artist. I think he wants to move in.
Well, he might be. But don't you worry about it.
What do you mean, don't worry? With the Green Hornet trying to move in, that settles it for me. I'm through. Find yourself another fence.
As a matter of fact, Tubbs, I was just about to call you and tell you that I was closing shop here in town.
I'm packing up everything and getting out. I'll be on my way in a couple of hours. When I'm gone, nobody will find me. So you just relax
and take it easy, you know.
Goodbye, Mr. Tubbs.
The pawn shop. Yep. We don't know any more now than when we started. We should have pushed him harder.
What happens with Mike? He's still facing a murder charge.
We have to make certain that the real killers don't leave this town.
Doesn't tell us much.
Maybe. Maybe not. Run the tape back to the beginning. Slow it down. There's a possibility.
Yeah, but nobody said anything.
The telephone dial did. Let's start from the top again.
Tubbs is tranquilized.
So I heard.
The last digit's 2. The complete number should be 555-8282.
All right. Now what?
This.
Let it go. Let the answering service handle it.
Hello. Is this the Metropolitan Hotel?
No, sir. You have the wrong number.
Well, isn't this 555-8282?
Yes, sir. But it isn't the Metropolitan Hotel.
Oh? Well, what is it then?
This is an answering service, sir. We have intercepted your call.
But the Metropolitan Hotel is listed as 555-8282. I just looked it up.
I'm sorry, sir, but the number you're calling is of Barton's Air Express service.
I'll be back in a minute. I'm going to file a flight plan.
A flight plan?
Yeah. Only we're not going to follow it. Wait here.
Do you read me?
Loud and clear. Do you want me?
Not yet. We've come to the right place. I've located some of the loot. I'll check further.
Someplace.
I just heard on the radio that Joe Tubbs is dead. Murdered.
Well, we'll talk about it later.
We'll talk about it now. And about Mike Axford.
Look, honey, I haven't got time to stand here and talk
Don't
to you
all. Honey, me, Yale. It won't work anymore. You lied to me. You had no intention of helping Mike.
Okay, so I lied.
Then I'll go to the police myself.
What about those wonderful plans we had? What about that wonderful life we were going to make together?
I don't want it anymore.
Well, I do. Put her in the police.
Let me go! No!
Vito? What's happened?
Get in here fast.
Get back. I'm using a sting.
They're getting away. We have to stop that plane.
Master Kato. Better use the rockets.
We can't. The girl's the key to Mike's cell. Try to slow it down. Take it up. Take it up. Leave the rest to them.
The district attorney said the burglary ring shipped most of its loot, including a fortune in furs, out of the city via an air express service owned by the gang's leader, Yale Barton. However, according to a confession given the authorities by Artis Ralston, the gang disposed of stolen jewelry through a local fence, Joe Tubbs. Tubbs was murdered when he became a threat to the gang. Meanwhile, back at city jail this morning, Daily Sentinel crime reporter Mike Axford was released and completely exonerated.
I still can't figure out how the DA got a line on that gang.
Well, why don't you ask him, Mike?
I did. And he just grinned and said a little bee told him.
You mean a bird, don't you, Mike?
Scanlon said a bee. And speaking of bees, being in jail gave me time to think. And I got a great new slant on the Green Hornet.
Oh?
You want to hear it?
Boy, I sure would like to, Mike, but I have a luncheon engagement.
Okay. But just get ready for the biggest news story of the year. Sentinel reporter on masks, Green Hornet.
Sure, sure, Mike. Good luck.
Now that's what burns me up.
What's that, Mike?
The way he sort of pats me on the head when I talk about the Green Hornet.
I guess you'll just have to get used to that, Mike.
The Green Hornet has been brought to you by...